Hello everyone, I'm Priyanka Shah and welcome to my YouTube channel Mathlite. In this video, we'll continue with exercise 6E from chapter Solving Problems Based on Quadratic Equations. So coming to question number 13. In a certain positive fraction, the denominator is greater than the numerator by 3. If 1 is subtracted from the numerator and the denominator both, the fraction reduces by 1 by 14. Find the fraction. There is a positive fraction, so we'll be considering positive numbers over here. Now, firstly, what is a fraction? It is numerator upon denominator. Fraction is numerator upon denominator. Now, denominator is greater than the numerator by 3. Denominator is greater by 3 than the numerator. So, let's take numerator as x. Okay. If we take numerator as x, denominator will be x plus 3, okay? It is greater than numerator by 3, okay? So this will become x plus 3. You can also take denominator as x, but that would not be preferable, okay? You will still get correct answer. If you take denominator as x, what will be the numerator? It is less than the denominator by 3, theek hai? So, if you take denominator as x, this will be the fraction. If you take numerator as x, this will be the fraction. Okay. So, this is the fraction. Now, there is one more fraction that is given to us. We are told that if 1 is subtracted from numerator and denominator both, if we subtract 1 from both, new fraction. We are subtracting 1 from the numerator and 1 from denominator. So it will become x minus 1 upon x plus 2. Okay. So this is new fraction. The fraction reduces by 1 by 14. This is the fraction having lesser value. Okay. So this fraction is the reduced fraction. This is the original fraction. Okay. So this is greater and this one is having lesser value. So greater minus lesser is equal to 1 by 14. Always more minus less we take. Okay. So the fraction reduces. New fraction reduces. Okay. So this is less. This is more. More minus less is equal to whatever the number is given to you. Okay. So old fraction is x upon x plus 3 minus new fraction is x minus 1 upon x plus 2 is equal to 1 by 14. So we need to solve this. We'll get a proper quadratic equation, and on solving that quadratic equation, we'll get the value of x. We have to find the fraction. Find the fraction, it is not mentioned new or old. So whenever it is not mentioned, you will consider the original fraction. Okay, that is this fraction. So once you get the value of x, you just need to substitute and find the fraction. So let us now write down the given in proper manner and start solving. So we have assumed the numerator to be x. Okay, so you have to write down, let the numerator be x. According to that, the denominator will be x plus 3. So the fraction will be x upon x plus 3. For the new fraction, we have to subtract 1 from both numerator and denominator. So it will become x minus 1 upon x plus 2. Now we are given the relation between original fraction and new fraction. So we know that new fraction is reducing, so it is less and this is more. So more minus less is equal to 1 by 14. So substitute the value of original fraction over here for new fraction, it is equal to 1 by 14. So now we'll solve this. So multiply numerator with the opposite denominator. So x into x plus 2, put the sign in between. Multiplying numerator with the opposite denominator. So x minus 1 into x plus 3. So Chris, put the sign in between, cross, and then multiply the denominators. So x plus 3 into x plus 2. So x square plus 2x we'll get on opening the brackets. Over here, x into x plus 3 and minus into minus 1 gives plus 1 into x plus 3. Okay, on opening the brackets over here, x became negative, and on opening the brackets over here, it will become plus 1. Okay, so be very, very careful with signs. Over here, x into x plus 2 plus 3 into x plus 2 is equal to 1 by 14. So x square plus 2x minus x into x gives x square minus into plus minus 3x. Over here, 1 into x gives x, and over here, 1 into 3 gives 3. So x square will get cancelled over here. Here we'll get x square plus 2x plus 3x plus 3 2s are 6 is equal to 1 upon 14. Over here in numerator, 2x, x minus 3x gives minus 2x. So this will get cancelled, plus 3 upon x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 1 by 14. So we get 3 upon x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 1 by 14. Now let's cross multiply. So 3 into 14, that will give 42, and 1 into x square plus 5x plus 6, that gives the same thing. Okay, so shifting 42 over here, I'm shifting 42 over here because I want x square to be positive. Okay, so x square plus 5x plus 6 minus 42, so that will give minus. Okay, greater number is negative. 42 minus 6 gives 36. So now switching the sides, I can say x square plus 5x minus 36 is equal to 0. We got a proper quadratic equation. Now sum and product. Sum is plus 5, product is minus 36. Now product negative hai. It means both the factors have opposite signs. Okay, one is positive, other is negative, and you have to subtract the factors to get the sum. Now 36 ka factors is very easy, we can do it mentally only. So 36, it is basically 9 fours are. Okay, 9 fours are 36, and on taking the difference we are getting 5. Okay, you can factorize and check. All right, so x square plus 9x minus 4x minus 36 is equal to 0. You will take plus 9, not minus 9 and plus 4, because if you take minus 9 and plus 4, sum will be minus 5, not plus 5. Okay, so be very careful with signs. Taking x common, x plus 9 bachega in the bracket. You're taking minus 4 common, x plus 9. Signs will change because we took minus outside the bracket. Theek hai? So x plus 9 in another bracket, x minus 4 is equal to 0. So x plus 9 is equal to 0, or x minus 4 is equal to 0. So x is minus 9, or x is equal to 4. Are we considering negative numbers? No, we are talking about positive fraction. So we'll neglect negative number. So is not a possibility. Okay, so therefore x is equal to 4. So now we need to find the original fraction. So original fraction is x upon x plus 3. So that is 4 upon 4 plus 3. So 4 upon. So write down the statement, the original fraction is 4 by 7. Let's read the next question, question number 14. In a two-digit number, the tens digit is bigger. The product of the digits is 27 and the difference between the two digits is 6. Find the number. Now, before proceeding with the question, let us go through one concept that we have learnt already in lower classes. Now, whenever you are considering a two-digit number, there is one thing that you need to keep in mind. Now, let's say there is a two-digit number 75. This is at units place and this is at tens place, right? So this we know. Now 7 and 5 are the digits. What is their place value? 5 is at units place, so it will be 5 into 1, that is 5 is the place value. 7 is at tens place, so into 10, and its value will be 7 into 10, that is 70. So 70 plus 5 is 75. Okay. Same thing if you consider 31. So this is at tens place, this is at units place. So this you will multiply by 10, this you will multiply by 1. So 3 into 10, 30 plus 1 into 1, 1. So 31 is the number. Okay. So I have considered only 2-digit number because the sum is about a 2-digit number. Now we'll use this concept in the sum over here. So place value is a very important concept that we'll be using in the sums. Okay. So in the question, we don't know which are the 2 digits. Let the 2 digits be x and y. Okay. Let's say x and y are the 2 digits. This is at units place, this is at tens place. Okay. Considering their place value also. So iska place value kya ho jayega? This will be multiplied by 1, this by 10. So it will become 10x plus 1 into y, y. So number is 10x plus y. The number will not be x, y, it will be 10x plus y. Okay. Now this is the number that we have to find. What are the conditions? The tens digit is bigger. So tens place pe there is x. So x is greater than y. That is what we are told. Tens digit is greater than units digit. What is the other condition given to us? The product of the digits is 27. So digits ka product bol rahe hai. Okay, not place value. Over here we'll not consider place value. So for the condition part, we are talking only about the digits. So product of the digits is 27. So x into y is 27. Okay. What is the other condition? The difference between the 2 digits is 6. So x minus y is equal to 6. Okay. Why not y minus x? X is greater than y. So greater minus smaller is equal to 6. Okay. Now over here for the number, we have 2 variables. For quadratic equation, we need only 1 variable. So what we'll do? We'll relate y with x. We'll write y in terms of x. So this condition will be useful for that. I can write y in terms of x. Just shift the terms. So x minus y is equal to 6. So x minus 6 is equal to y. Okay. So y is basically equal to x minus 6. Okay. So in place of y, I can write x minus 6. Okay. So over here in number also, I can say this is 10x plus x minus 6. So on solving, you will get 11x minus 6. Okay. Substituting x ka value in this also, you will get the number. Now, how will we get the quadratic equation? This other condition that we have not used, this will give you the quadratic equation. So x into y is equal to 27. What is y? Is equal to 27. So x square minus 6x is equal to 27. So x square minus 6x minus 27 is equal to 0. We got the quadratic equation. Okay. So on solving this, we'll get the value of x. Once you get the value of x, you can easily find out the number. Okay. You can substitute in this also or in this. Okay. We have to find the number only. We don't need to find digits. In case they tell you to find digits, then this is the equation in which you will substitute the value of x and y. Okay. X hum log ko mil jayega. Y is x minus 6. So you will get the value of y also. Okay. So let us now write down the given in proper manner and start solving. So the digit at the tens place is x and the digit at the units place is y. Okay. And we are told that the digit at the tens place is greater than the digit at units place. So x is greater than y. Okay. Now, considering the number, how will you find the number? X is at tens place, y is at units place. So this is ka place value kya ho jayega? Into 10 and yaha pe into 1. So this will become 10x and this will become y. Okay, this will remain y. So 10x plus y is the number, not x, y. So the number is 10x plus y. Now, the difference between the digits is 6. So x minus y is 6, not y minus x, because x is greater than y. So greater minus smaller. So x minus 6 is equal to y, shifting y over here and 6 over here. Okay. So y is basically x minus 6. Theek hai? So y is x minus 6. What is the other condition given? The product of the digits is 27. So x into y is equal to 27. So x into x minus 6 is equal to 27. So therefore we get a quadratic equation. Now again, this is a very easy quadratic equation. Okay, you can easily find out the factors. Sum is minus 6 and product is minus 27. Product negative hai, it means one factor is positive, other factor is negative. Now greater will be negative, sum ka sign is negative, so greater will be negative. Factors of 27, 9 threes are 27, okay. So minus 9 plus 3, okay, that will give you minus 6. Okay, if you take plus 9 and minus 3, you will get plus 6. So be careful with signs, okay. So plus 3 minus 9 will give you minus 6, and if you multiply, you will get minus 27. So splitting the middle term, x square minus 9x plus 3x minus 27 is equal to 0. So x into x minus 9 will remain the bracket, and over here 3 le liya, so x minus 9 remains in the bracket. So x minus 9 in another bracket, x plus 3 is equal to 0. So x minus 9 is equal to 0, or x plus 3 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 9, or x is equal to minus 3. We are not considering negative numbers, so this is not a possibility. We'll consider x as 9. Okay, so now let us find out the number. So make sure that you mention x is not equal to minus 3, because this is not a possibility over here. Now, x is equal to 9, right? So what is the number? The number is 10x plus y. So that is basically 10 into 9 plus y is what? X minus 6. So 90 plus x is 9 minus 6. So 90 plus 3, that gives 93. Okay. So 93 is the number. You have to write down final statement. The number is 93. Okay. So we found the number. If they are told you to find out the digits as well, 9 and 3 are the digits. But a proper way of showing is x and y are the digits, right? X kya hai? 9 hai. So digit at tens place is x. What about y? Y is x minus 6. So what would be the digit over here? It would be 9 minus 6, that is 3. Okay. So you need to show properly that way, that x is the digit at tens place, so x is equal to 9, and y is the digit at units place, so y is equal to x minus 6. Substitute the value of x and you will get the digit at units place. Okay, so don't forget the final statement. Coming to next question, question number 15. Some school children were on an excursion by a bus to a picnic spot at a distance of 300 km. While returning, it was raining and the bus had to reduce its speed by 5 km per hour, and it took 2 hours longer for returning. Find the time taken to return. A very easy question. This is a speed distance time problem. Okay. So there are school children who are going for a picnic to a certain spot. Okay, so from place A to B, it is 300 kilometer. So B to A bhi 300 kilometer hi hoga, provided they are following same path. Okay, so we'll be considering two journeys. One is onward journey, where they are going from school to the picnic spot, and other is return journey, jahan pe they are coming from the picnic spot to the school back. Okay, so there are two journeys. For that we'll consider distance, speed and time. Okay, distance is 300 kilometer. Okay, the picnic spot is at a distance of 300 kilometer. Now same will be the distance over here. We are assuming they are following the same path. Theek hai? So it will be same. What about the speed? They have not mentioned the speed with which the bus is going. So let's say the speed is x kilometer per hour. Okay. While returning, it was raining and the bus had to reduce its speed by 5 kilometer per hour. जो नॉर्मल स्पीड है उससे 5 किलोमीटर कम कर दिया. सो लेट्स से द स्पीड वाज x, तो अब क्या हो जाएगा, x माइनस 5 किलोमीटर पर आर. ओके, एंड इट टुक 2 आवर्स लॉन्गर फॉर रिटर्निंग. नाउ 2 आवर्स लॉन्गर, मोर लेस, ऑल दीज गिव यू कंडीशन, दे हेल्प यू इन फॉर्मिंग द इक्वेशन. Okay, so how will we use this? We'll come to this part later. Pehle hum log time find out karte hain. We know speed is equal to distance upon time. We know speed, we know distance, we can easily find out time. Time yahan pe shift karte hain, speed ko yahan shift karte hain. So time is distance upon speed. Okay, so distance is 300, speed is x, this will be in hours because speed is kilometer per hour. Okay, so this will also be in hours. Now what about the time taken over here? It will be 300 by x minus 5 hours, right? So time taken for onward journey is this much. Time taken for return journey is this much. Okay. Now, it took 2 hours longer for returning. It took more time over here. And here, less time. Because the speed was less over here and here the speed was more. Okay. So, more time taken minus less time taken is equal to how many hours ka difference? So more time taken is 300 upon x minus 5, less time is 300 upon x. Okay, basically time taken for return journey minus time taken for onward journey is equal to 2 hours. Okay, so if this is still confusing, what will you do? दोनों का time हम लोग को मिल गया है, numerator numerator same है, denominator check करो, यहाँ पे x है, यहाँ पे x minus 5 है, which will be greater and which one will be smaller? This one is greater, x is greater than x minus 5, x minus 5 smaller होगा, right? So denominator is greater means the value of this fraction will be lesser. Okay, so यहाँ पे time less होगा and यहाँ पे denominator is less, so there will be more value of the fraction. So यहाँ पे it will be more time taken. Okay, but easier would be यहाँ से ही तुमको directly मिल जाएगा. Okay, it took 2 hours longer for returning. So return journey is taking more time. So this is more time, this is less time. Okay, so we'll get a proper quadratic equation on solving this. So let us now write down the given in proper manner and start solving. So we have taken the speed for the onward journey to be x kilometer per hour. So make sure that you write down the statement at the beginning. Now the given wheel, write down in tabular format, that would be easier, okay? So there are two journeys, onward and return journey. Distance, speed and time taken, okay? Distance is going to be same for both the cases. Speed we have taken as x kilometer per hour for onward journey, so it will be x minus 5 because it is traveling with a lesser speed, 5 kilometer lesser speed, okay? Time taken will be distance upon speed, so 300 upon x over your 300 upon x minus 5 hours, okay? Now condition part, for return journey it is taking 2 hours more than the onward journey, so time taken for return journey more minus time taken for onward journey less, more minus less is equal to 2 hours, okay? So substituting the values, for return journey it is this much, for onward journey it is this much. Now we'll solve this. Now can we make the numbers in the numerator smaller? 300 302, so we can divide all the numbers by 2, okay? So dividing by 2 throughout, you can also solve without dividing, you will still get correct answer. So dividing by 2, 300 divided by 2 gives 150 upon x minus 5. Only the numerators are going to change, theek hai? This will also become 150, and 2 divided by 2 gives 1, okay? Now let's solve the LHS first. So Chris, that is numerator into opposite denominator, put the sign in between, cross numerator into opposite denominator. So Chris, put the sign in between, cross and then multiply the denominator. So x minus 5 into x. So 150x minus 150x minus minus plus ho jayega yahan pe, okay? 150 into 5, that will give 750 upon x square minus 5x is equal to 1. This will get cancelled, so we are left with 750 is equal to x square minus 5x, okay? Shifting this over here because I want x square to be positive, okay? You can solve it the other way, you will still get correct answer. Now switching the sides, x square minus 5x minus 750 is equal to 0. Let's solve this. Sum is minus 5, product is minus 750. Okay, product negative hai. It means ek factor negative hai, ek positive hai. Okay. Sum is negative, it means greater factor is negative, smaller factor is positive. And subtract karke we should get this. Okay. So let's find the factors of 750. 2, 3s are 6, 2 7s are 14 and 2 5s are 10. Okay. This is divisible by 3. So 3 1s are, 3 2s are, 3 5s are. 5 2s are 10, 5 5s are. 2 3s are 6, 6 5s are 30, and this is 25. 30 into 25 will give you 750, okay? And if you take the difference, you will get minus 5. So greater will be negative, smaller will be positive. So minus 30 plus 25 will give you minus 5, and when you multiply, you will get minus 750. So we'll split this. X square minus 30x plus 25x minus 750 is equal to 0. So taking x common, x minus 30, you're taking 25 common, in bracket x minus 25 30s are. Okay. So x minus 30 in one bracket and x plus 25 in another bracket. Now x minus 30 is equal to 0 or x plus 25 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 30 or x is equal to minus 25. X is speed. Speed cannot be negative. Okay. So x equal to minus 25 is not possible over here. Just write down. It is not a possibility because speed cannot be negative. Write down the reason. Okay. Therefore, x is equal to 30. What do we have to find? We have to find the time taken for return journey. So, we need to find time taken for return journey. We had got the equation. Look at the table. For return journey, it is 300 upon x minus 5 hours. So, substitute the value of x over here. 300 upon 30 minus 5. That gives 300 upon 25. So, 25 ones are, 5 remains. So, 50, 25 twos are. So, 12 hours. Okay. Don't forget the unit. Alright. So, write down the final statement. The time taken for return journey is 12 hours.